Hi there, Buick owners. Today on your 2022 Buick Envision, we're going to be taking a look at and showing you how to install CURT's Class 3 2-inch trailer hitch receiver.
And this is what our receiver looks like when it's installed. The cross tube does hang down below, but most of it is hidden by the bumper. There's just going to be a small portion across the bottom here. And unless you're getting down on your hands and knees like we are here, you're really never going to see that. You're just going to notice the receiver here at the back. It's tucked under pretty far, so that also helps ensure that it doesn't detract from the looks of the vehicle. This is a Class 3 2-inch by 2-inch receiver, so it's going to be great for all of your towing needs. Whether you're wanting to use this for accessories such as bike racks or cargo carriers, or if you wanted to use this to get a little bit of work done, you will be able to pull some smaller trailers with this hitch. You'll secure your accessories to your hitch using a 5/8 inch hitch pin and clip. Now, one doesn't come included with the hitch, but we've got plenty available here at etrailer, and you can get locking ones to protect your investments. On kind of a diagonal pattern here, or a diagonal plate here, going up towards the back, we have our safety cable connections, and it has a moderate size opening that should work with most of your safety cables. We've got a kind of a larger one there, and that one works out just fine with it. And this hitch features a 200-pound tongue weight, and that's the force going down on top of our receiver. Now, 200 pounds is a little bit low for a Class 3 2-inch hitch, but you should still be able to use a 2-bike platform rack with this with no issues, and depending on the weights of your bikes, you could potentially increase up to a 3 or 4-bike rack. Just pay close attention to those weights. You can also use a cargo carrier with it, but you're going to be able to hold some gear, but not going to be even coming close to loading it up to the max. You might be able to load it up about halfway, not even quite that, with the larger cargo carriers we have here. The largest carriers we have are about 550 pounds of max capacity that they can hold. But you want to keep in mind that the 200-pound tongue weight here on your hitch includes anything placed in the receiver. So that would be the weight of the bike rack or cargo carrier that you're going to use, and the weight of anything placed on it. So also add on the weight of those bikes you're going to put on that bike rack, or the weight of your gear you're going to load on that cargo carrier. So it is a little bit limiting there, but with the 2-inch size, it does open up a wide variety of accessories that will fit inside of it. It also features a 2,000-pound gross towing capacity, which is how much that you can pull behind it. And 2,000 pounds is enough to pull some smaller trailers if you've got some that you need to pull, like maybe a jet ski trailer, a John boat, you should be able to use those. Just some smaller utility trailers. Maybe you've got like a zero turn mower that you want to get a little bit of work done, or maybe you're helping out a family member, helping out grandma driving over there and taking care of her yard. Should be able to get stuff like that done. Just pay close attention to the weights of the items that you're going to be pulling to make sure you don't exceed that. I would also recommend that you verify in your vehicle's owner's manual and ensure you don't exceed any of its towing capacities. Now I've got some measurements for you to help you when deciding on accessories. From the center of our hitch pin hole to the edge of our rear bumper, we're right at about 7 inches. And this is important when determining if your accessories will contact the bumper when inserted into the receiver, and if they can be placed in the upright storage position without contacting the bumper. And from the ground to the top inside edge of our receiver tube, we're right at about 12 and a half inches. This is important when determining if you need a drop, a rise, or a raise shank on your accessories. And since this one does sit kind of on the low side, I would recommend a raise shank on your accessories.
So now that we've covered some of the features of our hitch, why don't you follow along with us in the shop and we'll show you how to get it installed. This is a very easy hitch to install. Something I would say you could probably get done in your driveway in about 25 to 30 minutes. We're going to begin our installation here at the back of the vehicle. We're going to feed our hardware into the frame. So you get these fish wires in your kit. They come kind of coiled up, just uncoil it there. And here we've got our coiled end. We're gonna take the end of this here, and we're gonna put just a little bit of a bend in it. That kind of makes it feed through the frame a little bit easier. And then right where our exhaust is here, straight up from the exhaust, you'll see some holes in the bottom of the frame. These are the holes that our hardware is gonna feed in. You have one there, and you have one here on the other side of the exhaust. Directly above the exhaust, you have a larger hole. That's our access hole. That's where we're gonna feed our coiled wire out of. So we're gonna go in the small hole here, angle it towards the rear, bring it out the large hole. We'll then take one of the spacers that comes in our kit and our bolt. We're gonna slide the spacer over the coiled end, and then we're gonna take the bolt, carriage bolts here in our kit, we're going to thread it on to the coiled end,
And then we're just gonna push these pieces up into the frame. Pull on our coiled wire until our bolt drops down. We're gonna repeat that same thing for the other hole here that's on this side. And then you have two holes in identical positions as this over on the passenger side of the vehicle. So we're gonna do it over there as well. And you may or may not wanna bend it a little bit more for the other hole, just because it's a little bit closer to that access hole. I'm gonna push your hardware on it the exact same way so we can pull it down. All right, so we're gonna get our hardware prepared in the same way over on the other side now. All right, now with an extra set of hands, we're gonna grab our hitch, take your pull wires and feed them down through the appropriate slot for where your bolts line up. So the furthest rear bolt's gonna go here and the further forward one goes there. We can then lift it right up above our exhaust, kind of angle it into position there. You may or may not need to push the bolts back up into the frame just a little bit in order to clear. But then we should be able to pull our bolts back down through the frame. We can go ahead and yank our pull wire off of there. And we'll take the nut that comes in our kit and we'll get it started on our bolt. Once you get one started on each side, the hitch will hold itself up, making it easier to install the rest of your hardware. All right, and then our other ones here that are directly above the exhaust, kind of, these ones are gonna be a little harder. Just be really careful not to push the bolt into the frame. What you can do sometimes is I'll take a hand and I'll push a little bit on the side of the bolt and then kind of thread the nut on with the other hand. That sideways pressure will help prevent the bolt from being able to push up into the frame. And now we'll take our 18 millimeter socket and we're gonna go back and snug them down. You should be able to get it in there. Probably gonna need an extension. A swivel socket can help for certain situations, but it really shouldn't be necessary as long as you got a nice long extension. Once we have them snugged down, we can go back with our torque wrench and torque it to the specification outlined in our instructions. And that completes our installation of CURT's Class 3 2-inch trailer hitch receiver on our 2022 Buick Envision.